So you're thinking of starting a music teaching business. Well, there's a lot to consider. What qualifications do you need? Should you teach from home or rent somewhere? What business considerations are there when starting a music teaching business? In this video, I'll give you all the foundations you need when you're just starting out. I've been a piano teacher for about 16 years now, and I wish I knew all this stuff right back at the beginning. Stick around for this full video and I'll give you a little bit of a jump start. Let's begin with some prerequisites or first steps. Number one, you need to be able to play the instrument that you're going to teach, right? Maybe it's a given, but let's just put that out there. If you are not a great player of your instrument of choice, you should not be teaching it. Number two, and this is the one that, amazingly, almost everyone misses out on, you need teaching skills. It's not just about being able to play. If you can play an instrument, it doesn't mean you can teach it, right? So you need teaching skills. Now, this could be that you go out and seek a degree or other qualification, or it could be something that you learn online through resources like Vibrant Music Teaching, which is my membership site, or other membership sites, other online courses. But you need to focus on your teaching skills, and that should be your top priority in the beginning. Number three of the basics that you need is somewhere to teach. You can't teach in the garden. Maybe you can, but you have to choose the spot that you're going to teach. Now, there are many places you could teach. You could teach in your home, in the corner of your living room, like I did for many, many years. I now have a separate room in my home, still teaching from my house. You could teach at students' houses. You might teach in a school as part of an agreement with them. There are many options, but you need to choose and pick out the spot where you're going to do your teaching. Now, the business side of things will depend on where you are, but you may need some kind of business license. And if you're teaching from home, you might need a license for that. Or you might need to just declare yourself self-employed. That would be the case for most people here in Ireland. But it varies around the world. So do check with your local offices, your local government. Most areas will have some kind of entrepreneur program or small business support that you can reach out to and find out what it is that you need. Now, what you don't need is a big investment or a bunch of red tape. So as far as new businesses go, starting a music teaching business is fairly low cost and a small investment of your time in terms of setup. All right, let's get this moving. So now you're going to choose where you're going to teach or whether you're going to offer different options. Many teachers will teach at home, but also travel to students' houses in the beginning. So if you're going to offer options, definitely set that all out for yourself now. Quick sidebar, this is really important. If you are going to go to students' houses, please charge more for that. Don't undersell that part of it. It is so valuable to parents. When I started out teaching, I did go to students' houses and I did not charge enough for it. So please charge what you're worth, charge a substantial travel fee that will cover the costs of your travel time to the students' houses. Speaking of which, how much are you going to charge in general? You need to research the local market and the going rates in your area. It varies so much. There's no point me even suggesting a rate here. You need to do your local research, find out what other teachers are charging or similar services are charging. And when you do find out, please do not try to undercut anyone. That just drives us all to the bottom. And honestly, you're not going to get high quality students going that route. You should charge maybe less than the expert teacher who's been teaching for 50 years, but you do not have to go to the bottom of the market. That is not the route to success. Now it's time to set things up, and you want to get started on the right foot. So write out a list of simple policies, a fee list. So if you have different rates for different lengths of lessons or different locations, write them out in a list, and then a calendar. This set of three pages is ideal for starting out as your studio. You don't have to be complicated and should be three pages long. Just one page of policies, a one page calendar, and a page with your fees on it. Set these up in Word or Google Docs or whatever program you're comfortable using so that they look simple but professional. Now it's time to find your first students. Will you be my student? Will you be my student? Aside from asking friends and family, you can absolutely try putting out some flyers, putting out local posters on local message boards. But what I really recommend, if you're getting serious about this, set up a website. Doesn't have to be complicated, but it is the number one way that you will find students as a brand new teacher. Ready? Here we go with four top tips to get you rolling. My first top tip is a reiteration. Do not undercut the people in your area. It will not help you. It will not help them. It won't get you high quality students. It's not a good route. Number two, decide when you want to teach and when you don't. A lot of people will be balancing this alongside another career, another job, or other commitments in your life. And if you're not careful, you're going to fill every available spot with teaching. So decide right now, up front, are you going to teach Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or do you need some days off? If you don't decide this up front, it's going to end up patchy. So just decide on your days right now while watching this video or later today and stick to that. Tip number three goes right alongside that, and that is to protect your non-business hours. If you're going to take Sundays off, really take them off. Don't answer email, don't take phone calls, don't reply to texts on Sundays. And number four, and this is the most important thing, which is why I want to leave you with it, is to invest in your own professional development and take that side of it seriously. The teaching is the most important part. Yes, you need to be able to play, but I suspect you already have that covered. The thing you need to focus on the most is your teaching. Your teaching skills, the pedagogy, invest in that. Purchase courses, spend time researching. Really focus on that in the beginning so that you can become a great teacher that people want to refer others to. So that will get you started with starting your music teaching business. If you want more on this and on the basics of teaching, especially piano teaching, we have a fantastic course for you inside Vibrant Music Teaching. Just click in the link in the description to find out more about Vibrant Music Teaching membership and that course, and I'll see you over there.